to another episode of Entrepreneurs in Fuego, Season 3. I'm here with my new best friend and my brother, Curran Vincent. Rock the boat, baby.
Rock the boat. Well, so at Chandler Gilbert Community College,
yes,
for beginning this month, September the 13th, we'll be doing a rollout for a series of voter education registration events that we're planning through November the 1st.
Okay.
The rollout is going to be, again, on September the 13th, and it's going to be really just food, speakers, entertainment. We'll be doing interviews, and we'll be streaming it throughout all the college campuses. Maricopa Community College District is one of the largest, well, it is the largest community college district in the country.
It is.
So we're going to be streaming across the campuses to kind of engage the district as a whole into the process of civic engagement, which seems to be the push for the new director of civic engagement for the district, Lawrence Robinson.
Civic engagement, why is it that civism, I don't want to say is dead, but why is it that decline in civism? I mean, why are we not much more engaged into our political process as we should? Is it because we're apathetic about it? We just listen to what the media is saying right now, Curran, and we're just like, I don't want to vote for him or I want to vote for her.
Well, I think what's happening is we've reached a point where it's time to evolve. You know, there was a time when it really was just about being able to vote, especially if you were one of the underserved of the country, whether you were African American, Latin American, a woman,
yeah,
or anything like that. You just wanted to be able to participate. Well, then that barrier had fallen, and then it became about the level of participation. Well, now we've reached a point, in my opinion, in that process where it's time for us to evolve and become knowledgeable about the things that we are being engaged in, the things that they're talking about. A great example, our first forum, which is happening on September the 27th, mm-hmm, is about immigration reform.
Okay.
Looking into this and really studying about it, you know, when people in this state in particular, and you talk about immigration issues, your mind flashes to a certain demographic automatically, not really realizing that a couple of things. Immigration has fallen consistently across the board over the last, since 2005.
As a matter of fact, there's a net zero,
yeah,
this year. And interestingly, contrary to the popular perception, you know, for the people that come here to this country and overstay their visas,
yeah,
the majority of those are Europeans.
Are Europeans,
they're,
exactly.
You know, 43,000 versus 193,000 from Europe. So,
yeah,
you know, there is a lot of noise out there that,
right,
you know, that I think that what you do and what your organization does, Curran, is educate people.
That's
Look,
exactly
we're going to,
yeah,
talk about this subject, which is immigration, but let's educate ourselves.
Right.
Before, you know, giving an opinion about what it is,
right,
what we think about,
right,
this,
the way that the way that the forums are going to be constructed is we're going to have representatives from both parties to present their points of views or present their party's point of view, and we'll have an academic there. You,
right,
know, I'm going to be moderating the discussion, but really, all I want is the information. You know,
moderating that discussion is going to be a little bit challenging.
It's going to be challenging. But at the end of
to
the
try to keep it on subject, to try to keep it on point.
Right. Well, and to try to keep my opinion out of it, you know, because ultimately what where I feel like we need to get to as a culture to get past this kind of malaise that you spoke of earlier is I think we need to really engage ourselves and see, wow, when they're talking about immigration reform, what does that mean? And who does that mean? And then, historically, America has a terrible time dealing with immigration because what we tend to do is institute a series of programs that really kind of excite racism, you know. So how do we approach this without creating a whole other subculture of racism?
And indeed, to go to your point, traditionally and historically, when you look at the United States, every time that the two parties have been weak, there's always racism and there's always immigration, the one that we find the culprit on and the,
right,
one that we're going to blame.
We're going to blame it on them.
Exactly.
Right.
We're going to blame everything to the immigrants.
Right.
Every malaise,
right,
is to the immigrants.
Right.
And to the point that you should keep your point of view away from it, I don't think so. I wouldn't. Because,
right,
in fact, how can you keep, you know, one's point of view when, for instance, the voter registration laws,
mm-hmm,
that thankfully enough, the Supreme Court just threw out over in North Carolina and South Carolina.
Yeah.
Come on. I mean, those that's voter suppression right there.
Right.
I mean, that, that has nothing to do with one party or another. It has to do with the fact that our minorities are being deprived from exercising their right to exercise their opinion or their vote. Heck, I'd be moderating that thing and go, no, you're wrong. You're suppressing my vote.
Well, see, but the thing is, the information, what we want to do is establish a brand of being unbiased and let the information speak for itself. You know, wrong is wrong. I believe that every human being has a sense for that. Now, you know, there are different things that factor in and will divert us from the right path.
Right.
But the information being there, when you realize, again, the immigration forum, when you realize that the number one, the main, our main influx of immigration is coming from Europe and East Asia.
Right.
That's contrary to what most people probably think or would believe.
Correct.
You know, given all the rhetoric that we see on television, most people would think that we're being overrun from our borders, you know, by immigrants, not realizing that immigration has been in decline since 2005.
Exactly. And going back again to that, all right, so the big problem, people that overstay their visas, 93,000 from Canada, over 200,000 from Europe.
Yeah.
And there's 43,000 only from, you know, Latin countries.
Absolutely.
Come on. Those are very disparaging figures. So let's talk about facts.
So let's get the facts out.
Don't spin those facts.
Right. So you being a member of the audience would be like, you know what? Those, some people are going to hear those facts and say, I don't believe those. And they're going to go look themselves and see that the information is there.
Right.
Other people will be like, I had no idea. Based on what was being said by this one political party, I thought we had, you know, barbarians at the gate. They were about to overthrow us. The realities of what we're being told by the media in mass and what they actually are wholly different. But just the other side of that is that we are at a time where there actually is stuff happening around the world. There actually are people that want to come into this country and hurt Americans. They don't care who you are, where you're from. So how do we not go too far with immigration reform, but at the same time keep America and Americans safe? That's the other side of the conversation.
We want to be welcoming and we want to be safe at the same
time. Right, we want to be safe at the same
time. Let me ask a question. Should voting, and I understand it's a privilege that we have by living in this country, should it be a mandate? Should it be a requirement that we all vote when we are 18 or older?
Wow, you know what? That's a great question. And I think that voting is such an important part of what we do. And I think it's again, what makes our democracy kind of great. You know, one of the things that President Obama said during his commemoration of Selma, he said that our democracy isn't great because it's perfect. It's great because it can change, and it has shown its ability to change. Being made to vote, being suppressed, repressed from voting, has made no difference, because ultimately we keep making these advances past slavery, past racism, past, you know, sexism.
Albeit slow, but progress is always going this way.
It's always going that way.
Right.
So I don't know that a mandate is necessary. What I think is important is that we get around this idea that in order for each one of us to succeed, somebody else has to fail, or somebody else has to be to blame if we ourselves aren't meeting our own goals and challenges. So I think that's the evolution of where we're trying to go as a culture. And I think that we're at a point right now where we are becoming apathetic because we don't know what to do to push past that. And I think that now's the time. You know, we're seeing things that are happening in the political parties that we're questioning both parties. You know, the Republicans have issues, the Democrats have issues, and we're wondering, what can we do at this point where there's something that we can do? You talk to, you know, 18 to 30-year-old Republicans, and they have an idea of what the Republican Party should look like in the 21st century. Same thing for the 18 to 30-year-old Democrat. They have an idea. And in order to engage those ideas, it's time for us as a community to get together and have intelligent, non-vitriolic discussions about where we go. And I think that one of the great things about what we're doing at Chandler Gilbert and in Maricopa Community College District, is that we're bringing that into the community, onto a campus that's perfectly accessible to all members of the community. Come, see, talk, and engage in what we're doing there.
Invention, man. Bringing common sense to where there is chaos.
That's what we're trying to do.
In politics, and bringing just sanity where there is complete insanity into politics.
Yeah.
Love what you do, my brother.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, man. I appreciate it.
I appreciate shows like yours that give us an opportunity to let people know that, you know, there is a movement, you know, to help engage everybody and to kind of, you know, reinvigorate democracy in this country.
Leave it about for me.
Oh, man, I really don't know.
Edit, cut. With that, we're out.